All right, welcome to a Modern Horizons 2 draft here on ChannelFireball.com. And we got an Urban Dagger Tooth down there. Our rare, terrible card. Magus the Bridge, really bad. Doesn't do it. Don't mind Glorious Enforcer. I do like Junkwinder. This costs less for every token you have. Then when you play a token, it taps and locks something down. And if you can get like some good token enablers, this card really goes off. It's a pretty cool card. There's also Sinister Starfish, but nah. Let's go ahead and just grab the Junkwinder here, see what we can end up with. See, like, for example, Wave Sifter. You get to make two tokens. Two investigate tokens. There's also Territorial Kavu, but I'm not, like, in love with that card. And I like being in, like, blue-green tokens to start here. There's also Rift Sower, I think, is a pretty good card. If you have this in your opening hand, it taps for any color. And but I kind of like Wave Sifter here to go with this Junkwinder. I don't know. This card's sweet. It's the Mole Drifter of the set, kind of. You get a 3-2 flyer instead of a 2-2, but the tokens are obviously a lot harder to use than just drawing a card. All right, what do we got? Ooh, Enchantress's Presence. That's funny. I might just take the bridge here. Mana is generally pretty good. Don't love Abundant Harvest. Yeah, let's just take the red blue land. This is a lot of stuff. Junkwinder could have been a 5/7, yes. There's a MH2 card I may have seen underperforming that ended up impressing me in the long run. That's a kind of weird. You're asking like what card is maybe underrated? I don't know. I haven't played like tons and tons of it, so. Lucid Dreams draws me like 2 to 4 cards. Also Trap Runner, when it attacks, flip 3 coins and you get a thing for every flip, sure. Not really too impressed with any of these things, but I might just take Lucid Dreams here. It's not gonna be too hard to draw a couple cards off this, I don't know. Ooh, don't mind the Burden Aerialist in general. Because it's a 3-1 when you sack a token, it gets flying, but also it makes a token when it comes in, which is pretty nice. So, kind of like that. Over Flourishing Strike, Jade Avenger, the Frog Samurai. there's a bunch of MH2 cards I think we're going to put in the cube, but we're not sure what those are quite yet. Yeah, this is a cool card. I like the art too. The flavor on this card is amazing. So it makes a treasure token, and then when the treasure token gets sacrificed, like it's letting go of the treasure token, it can fly even higher. Pretty good. A cube that has 12 Squadron Hawks, that's called drafting Cold Snap. A lot of that action, if that's what you're looking for. Destroy some tokens with Gorilla Shaman. Little Diamond Hands Ape. There's also Infiltrator. I don't really like that one too much. Arcbound Javelinator is not a bad card. But I'm kind of in for Gorilla Shaman. There's some matchups where Gorilla Shaman I think is gassy. I don't really like... What else is going on here? I guess I'll take Raving Visionary. I think this card is pretty sweet. There's a lot of tokens in this set. There is. So we're maybe like red, blue, green tokens / Delirium. The Cobra's decent too. Yeah, it's fine. I don't like that the Cobra only gives you the token on death. So sometimes it doesn't fix your mana right away, whereas the Aerialist does, and they both usually trade off fairly well. So. This is me and Gabby holding on to our AMC stock. Mostly forgetting about it. Then it went up again. It's just meme stocks. Altar of the Goyf. Nah. Revolutionaryist. Madness, but I'm not really going to be too madnessy. Let's just take another Burdened Aerialist. Really can't go wrong with this. Mm-hmm. Just make the junk winder come out. Yeah, they are. Oh yeah, this card was definitely a vintage playable. So is Flying Man. That was a long time ago. Very, very sweet. Ultra the Goyf is a cool card, but I'm hoping this deck won't really want to use it. No, the 6/6 Trample Dino is pretty bad, I think. I think I might just take Mishra's Factory. This card's really strong for a land. Like, you can just play this as a spell, and it's still good, because it's a 3/3 blocker. It's going to be, I think, pretty effective in general. Yeah, Factory's good. What are we missing? Well, we would love offering to the Fae the enchantment that gives you the token of each type if you play a creature and a non-creature. This doesn't really look like any cards I would play. I don't think the Glimmer Baron is particularly good. I'll take Sinister Starfish. This card's actually good, though I'm not really that likely to play it here. There's a lot of crossover between archetypes in the set, which is, I think, pretty interesting. Which is pretty cool. Also, we have 5 blue cards, 1 green card, 1 red card, and a red-blue land. We're really not committed to anything at this point. Oh, well, Stormglade's Oracle is quite strong. It's a 1/3 that when it dies, deals 3 to everything. But Battle Plan, one of the strengths of Battle Plan is it's got basic land cycling, which there's 2 reasons I like this, and I'm going to take it. One is it fixes my colors. The other is this puts an enchantment in your graveyard, which is pretty good for the Delirium cards. Right now, I only have kind of 2, but it's not that hard to get more of those. And that is, I think, a pretty strong thing. Maybe I'll play the Trap Runner. Take the Faithless Salvaging, but I'm probably not going to. Hey, what's up, Windred? I mean, it gives you things that are tapped and attacking, but Tavern Scoundrel's kind of interesting. The problem with the goblins is like they, ooh, Ignoble Hierarch. They're tapped and attacking, so they just die a lot of the time. Ignoble Hierarch's pretty interesting. I mean, I'd rather be green than red anyway. Like, these cards are all medium. Like, I can splash these for later. And I think that the Hierarch's going to be quite good. This is not Phantom, no. This is real. I don't even know what this card's worth. But what's the next best card? Sweep Disguise, probably. Yeah, let's just take the Hierarch. I think that card's pretty sweet. Well, I got to Sweep Disguise anyway. I mean, this is blue X makes like 1 for each color. So what often happens, you play blue, let's say blue red green, 4 mana for 3 tokens, which is pretty nice. Yeah, nothing else here really competes. Oh, Kaleidoscorch isn't bad. This is going to be 2 mana, deal 2, flashback, 5 mana, deal like 3 to 5. There's also another Raving Visionary, which is pretty strong. The green-blue land, I actually don't mind the land at all. I think I might want Kaleidoscorch, though. It seems like that's going to be a pretty good one for me. Ooh, Yavimaya Elder goes from being a killer cube card to a great MH2 card. Yeah, but Elder is going to help me do all the things I want to do here, which is nice. Oh, man, this is nice, too. Road to Ruin is great. 3 mana, you get a basic land tapped, and then for 3 more mana, you get to then cast it from a graveyard and kill any creature. I mean, I like Orchard Strider as well, the land cycling one, but this one's actually really good. Tavern Scoundrel is interesting, but I don't think that's where I want to be. Yes, this is also 2 types for Delirium. I could use some Prophetic Titans. That's what I could use. Another Lucid Dreams. No, we're just going to take Orchard Strider. This is what I want. Yeah. Basic land cycling lets you cycle this for 1 and a green and get any basic land and put it in your hand, which is pretty nice given the where this deck is going. Oh, yeah, the Tavern Scoundrel plus Trap Runner. Sure, yeah, that's pretty funny. Squirrel Sanctuary, yeah, that's playable. I think it's playable in the Squirrel decks. not so playable outside the scroll decks. I'm pretty solidly teamer at this point, but I'm probably going to have like a blue-green splash red mana base, because these also fix any color, so I'll have like a bunch of fixing in blue and green. Though I guess battle plan is also kind of fixing. Plus, casting this isn't the worst in the world. You have a flyer out, you're like, attack for five with a wave sifter or something. Orchard Star is nice because when you cast it, it also makes tokens. So don't mind where we're at here. Scuttletide. Ooh, I don't hate that one. You discard a card to make an 03 blue crab. And if you have delirium, your crabs get +1/+1. So I can make a lot of tokens for the Junkwinder. Yeah, I'm kind of in for Scuttletide here over the blue-red land. Oh, interesting. Mystic Redaction is pretty good with Scuttletide. You discard and you mill them. And there's also Raven Visionary to some degree. It's mostly that. I kind of like that. So the reason I kind of like that is I might not even main deck the Mystic Redaction. I've played a lot of control mirrors here where you just want a bunch of mill cards here. I could take a second Trap Runner and I can maybe pick up another Tavern Scoundrel. I don't know. We'll see. Hey, what's up, Heavenly Evan? The 7-month Adi Sabrina. Okay. So Shiny's fine. I think that's decent. Not super impressive, but it's fine. Ooh, Mog Salvage, I think, is a pretty good sideboard card. You get to cast this. It's a Shatter you cast for free if you have a Mountain and they have an Island. Don't really like lose focus all that much. Torque Gorilla Shaman is cute, I suppose, but I'm not going to play any of these cards, I don't think. I might play Lose Focus as a sideboard card. Don't think I'm going to play. Nah. These are all bad. All right. Kind of need some action still. Fey Offering would be nice. Extruder would be pretty nice. The Tireless Tracker that makes food and stuff would be pretty nice. I don't know. Feels like we're missing something here. So many rares. Ooh, does anyone know what Solitude is worth? Just out of curiosity. there's a Turok's Canticle down there. It's also Chainer Nightmare. Solitude's worth 34 ticks. That's interesting. Chainer Nightmare Adept. So, 3/2, and you can discard a card to cast creatures out of your graveyard. That's pretty strong. There's also Verdant Command is playable, but not particularly great. Let's see. Yeah, no, Chainer seems really good, but Solitude seems like it's really worth a lot, so we're going to go this direction. Let's just put it that way. Maybe we'll splash Solitude. You never know. I think I'm just going to take another Road to Ruin here. This card is great. Yeah, really hard to go wrong with this. Yeah, we might splash this card as going in our sideboard. This card is really good, though. The Arcus Acolyte. Then again, there's another Wave Sifter here. There's also Fast and the Furious. Oh, such a good name. But I don't know how good this is. I'll just take Wave Sifter. I think Wave Sifter's awesome. Ooh, Counterspell's interesting. I could definitely see Counterspell being good enough. I guess I'm not going to play. I don't really want to play any of these black cards. Yeah, sure. I'll put Counterspells in my deck. Why not? Well, there's a black card I guess I wouldn't mind playing. Bone Shredder is good. So if I played Bone Shredder, I don't have any combos with it currently, no. I could easily splash it though. Yeah, this is just a really good card. I mean, the rest of the pack is just not cards that are not as good, so I'll take the good card. So this is cheaper with artifacts, but I don't really have that much of a good combo or token generating set. I've got some like wave sifters or whatever. I guess the crabs aren't artifacts. That doesn't really help. I don't think I want Lightning Spear either. It seems like a bad bolt. There's also Chrome Courier, which is a fine card. I don't really like any of this stuff. Did we get that on the winder? Yeah, I think with Scuttletide, we probably did. Let's take Slagstrider, though. I'm not really that likely to play it. Another Burdened Aerialist. Might just want to take a blue-green land at this point. Though, I could use maybe another draw card. That actually helps enable the Scuttletide. Let's take a second Lucid Dreams. We don't have a lot of card draw right now. Ooh, now there's Hard Evidence, which I actually don't mind. Hey, what's up, D-Viking? Welcome back. 14 months. This is tough. Hard Evidence is interesting. But then again, a blue-red land is going to be pretty good in this deck. Yeah, let's just take the land. Abundant Harvest. Oh, another battle plan. Okay. Yeah, this is just going to make my Delirium a lot more consistent having those. This is 25, the 22 playables right now. I'm drafting on Magic Online. I'm not drafting on a website, though I understand why you might be confused. Yeah, I'm not seeing anything in my sideboard I really want to play here. I mean, I guess if I have Delirium Gouge Zeal, it's actually pretty good. But yeah, let's just put it in the sideboard for now. Ooh, Seal of Removal, another battle plan. They both kind of do the same thing. There's also, I mean, I guess I probably don't mind just playing Seal of Removal in general, I think. Liquid Metal Torque, in case I really want to get this Gorilla Shaman going on. I just take the Bottle Golems. Ooh, I'll take Spreading Insurrection. There's some matchups where I could see that doing the thing. I don't know if I'm going to actually play the Seal of Removal now that I think about it. It's good with like Bone Shredder, but that's like basically it. Oh, I'm not arguing that Magic Online is good. Trust me, I am not. But if you're going to draft Modern Horizons 2, that's what you got. So this is 23. Well, I mean, I was thinking about whether I wanted to play Factory as a land, but I kind of don't because I have three Land Cyclers. And I have a Mana Dork. And I have two cards that go fetch lands. So, yeah, I think I can probably get away with 17. Hey, Omritu, welcome. One Swamp for sure. Seven Islands. That's probably too many. By a lot. So if I do this... Oh, I have six green sources. I really want a seventh green source. Six blue, but then two, four red, but then I've got some land cyclers in all the colors. And I've burdened aerialists. Kind of want to do something like this, actually, because with the two battle plans. Okay. I don't know how good this deck is. I don't think this deck's very good. Seems like it kind of missed. We'll see. This looks... If I had to guess my record, it's probably 1-2 is more likely than 2-1, but we'll see, we'll see. We didn't splash Solitude. Close, though. Close. How do you assess whether a deck is good or not? Well, it's a combination of things. The mana base is a little medium. They don't have as good of high end. Like, you can have some really good high end in this set. I really don't. So those two things in concert are pretty bad, I think. Mm-hmm. Oh, I see what you're saying. 3,400. I get it now, Molly. That makes a lot of sense. Mm-hmm. Oh, I actually got an ignoble hierarch too. I love drafting non-phantom. I don't know. It's cool caring about the cards you open. Yeah, I mean, if I get Junkwinder down and it can protect it, like, it's really good with Scuttletide. It just, that's going to kill them really quickly. I have a bunch of card draws, so I don't know. It's not the end of the world here, but we'll see. Sedge. Mulligan that. Well, this hand's pretty good. Because I get to double accelerate, and I'm going to get to cast Elusive Dreams for, I would say, a decent amount. We'll see. See how things end up going. Hey, what's up, Squirrel? 6 to 8 months. Will Squirrels prevail in the LR versus Little Shodan? We'll see. We'll see. And I think I'm probably going to have my new computer ready to go by then, too. That's the cool part. Let's get another forest here. Draw. All manas, huh? I'm not loving this. Yes, we are doing LR versus LoL Showdown this Thursday for Modern Horizons 2. Pretty hyped for that. Let's not cycle this. I'm just going to cast the Orchard Strider. I'm going to cast a Wave Sifter on turn 5, and I'm going to cast an Orchard Strider on turn 6. Draw land, Wave Sifter. All right, then we can sweep the skies, and then pretty good chance we'll draw like at least three cards off the thing. I wanted to play the land, even though, yes, discarding it could help, because I'm sorry. This, okay, unblock. They just sacked their thing to do nothing. Rough. That's rough, buddy. Smash. And next turn, I can cast Sweep for a good amount. Oh, what is this? I'm not loving whatever they're tapping 6 mana for. What happened there is they exploited sacrificing a creature, which destroys target creature you don't control with mana value 3 or less, but this costs 5. So, that's what happened there. I guess I'm going to hit with my two things and see what's going on. No real reason to play the Hierarch because I'm not blocking here. Arena Cube was awesome. I love Arena Cube. All right. Make some tokens, so sweep the skies, and might as well play the Hierarch too. Ooh, I did get Marshall in the Arena Cube as well. What's one card I'd want to see in a sealed MH2 pool? Urza Saga is pretty high on the list. That card's amazing. Yeah, I guess I'll keep this. If I draw a red Land Cycler, a Burdened Aerialist, or a green source, my mana's fine here. Oh yeah, Burnt Orange Wolf or Cabin Cubes were great. I'm not even going to play the Gorilla Shaman. It doesn't really accomplish anything to have in play, I don't think. Like, I'd rather them spend mana making a clue or something. Yeah, the green Land Cycler, nice. What are you getting with Urza Saga and Sealed Pool? Yeah, 2 5/5s mostly. That's like the main thing you're getting. Ooh. Okay. Do I want to cast So Shiny? Yeah, sure. I don't know. Nothing really better to do. And I'm going to play Sweep the Skies next turn. So I think getting that in play is good. Oh. Not an artifact. This is an artifact. Yeah, okay. That doesn't work then. Another Floodhound. Well, they got me, I guess. What happened first game? We played some things and they conceded mostly. This is what happened. Yeah, that's a good question, Monty. What percent of the designs had to do with, or design process had to do with making these indestructible? I don't think it was actually that much, if I had to guess. And the reason is that this was a kind of natural place to take artifact lands, and I think just making them indestructible is a good decision, whether or not specifically Gorilla Shaman was in. But the flip side of that is if, let's say, they wanted to make these and not be indestructible, they just wouldn't put Gorilla Shaman in the set. Is, in my opinion. All right, I guess I'll cast a 1/1 flyer. I don't know. All right, well, I would have been able to cast that, but what can you do? Sure. I think I'll just attack for 3. I could... You know, I'm just going to play this Gorilla Shaman now. If they want to attack with a spinner into it, I'm into it as well. Yeah, I'm not saying other artifact removal wouldn't leave either, but there's just no way you print Gorilla Shaman with common artifact lands that you can destroy here. Boom. let's attack. I really don't know what they could have. They're not really doing anything. All right, let's play this. The land you get off the road is tapped, unfortunately, so I couldn't play both. Basic land cycling that on 5. I'm really unclear. Okay, that was kind of a weird match where they just didn't do anything, so I guess there was there. Yeah, that makes sense, Shivam. You wouldn't want to print in Soul Artifact either. There is an in Soul Artifact at Rare. Right? Whatever it's called. So that one's kind of cool, but Rare is fine. Yeah, the Overload one. That's the one I was thinking of, yes. Rise and Shine. Yeah, there we go. I like it. Yeah, making artifacts, indestructible artifacts into things with like Ensoul Artifact on Darksteel Citadel was pretty cool. Any possibility Rise and Shine seems modern play? I don't think it's out of the question, but let's play. Oh yeah. Oh yeah, this Yavimaya Elder is going to help us fix mana once we draw all our green. Well, the truth is, once we draw one green source, we'll have a second. So there is that. Oh, no. Tide Shaper. I mean, I guess I'll just have to play my... Yeah, Bone Shredder here, because I don't really want that thing around. This card's good. It turns your thing into an island for as long as Tide Shaper's around. Pretty strong card. It was about to mess up my mana there, and it's a 2-mana 2/2. This is no longer... The island is no longer a mountain, no. Ooh, Ornithopter of Paradise. Interesting. So, yeah, we'll pay. It might seem weird how aggressively I pay for Bone Shredder, but it's a free 1-1 flyer. That's like definitely worth something. Even against an 0-2 flyer, so I can't really attack, but... See, like, next turn now I can Sweep the Skies for 4 tokens. Pretty good. They have access to lots of colors of mana, though. I don't really love that. Ooh, 4/3. Okay, that's fine. And then I don't actually want to trade three tokens for this thing. We'll see what they do. Because I can kill it with a ruin here. They have four cards. I also have Raven Visionary here. Let's see what they got. Ooh, Ethereum Spinner. That one is good. Usually good to cast before your filigree. Oh, never mind. Dear Lord. Okay. 2/2 flying. It's a Mole Drifter with affinity for artifacts, but it also triggers the Ethereum Spinner. Okay, I guess I'm going to have to block the Filigree Attendant if they attack with it. I don't like this. Don't like this at all. Yeah. Keep the Bone Shredder around because I have ways to bounce that maybe. Yeah, that was a pretty good turn. Kind of why I was worried about our deck. I'm going to get the island because I, or the forest, because then I can yob my elder into the mountain. So what am I hoping to draw here? Sure. That's not too bad. I mean, I guess I'm not dying that quickly. That's pretty good. A free 4/4 into a 2/2? Yeah. Oh, nice storm count. Yeah, I guess I'll trade tokens here. I don't know. I'm gonna have to kill something here. A little late to the party counterspell. All right, let's play this. Let's play our island pass here. And then the reason I play the island is because I want to be able to activate Elder and then activate Raving Visionary and then still cast counterspell on whatever they play. They're going to exile my Road to Ruin here. Sure. Well, if that gets the Kavu to attack, I don't mind that too much because Mishra's Fracture gets a free eat here. Okay, block there, block there, block there. Oh, they're sending in the... hold on. I do want to kill that. The question is, do I want to kill the 3-1? I don't really... I want to sack the Elder to draw a card. I think I do need to do that. The question is, I think I'd rather kill this one over that one. Yeah, but that leaves them with a bunch of flyers. This one's so hard to beat if it continues. All right, let's do that. I guess I give up the ability to have counterspell this turn. That's fine. I definitely get a mountain. I get a forest. Draw a card. I can loot away that for delirium. 12. Ugh, another one of those. Okay. Well, at least they played it after the spinner died. That's pretty nice. Okay. Not loving this situation. Guess we'll play Island again. Okay. Fortunately, I just have to block that there now. Okay, so I'm going to take 7, but I'm only going to lose one of these creatures because I get to pump factory. Mishra's Factory is a really good card. It's gotten a lot of value here. I'm not going to use the looter because I want to counterspell if they had something. If they didn't, I'll just crack the clue. Okay. Let's just start, I guess. Oh, wait. No, I should do this first. So shiny. I still think on the Sojourner's Companion. Mm-hmm. Scry 2. Gorilla Shaman doesn't do it. Orchard Strider actually is really good. So kind of slight regrets for where that the So Shiny went, but that's okay. Huh. Get in there. Okay, I go to 2. They got nothing? All right. No, they exiled my graveyard removal with their attacking thing. Oh, interesting. Okay. Play Seal of Removal, and I think I just pass here. And then... Oh, that's an instant? Huh. Weird. Sure. Why would that card be an instant? Oh, for Delirium, I guess. Interesting. Oh, man, I hope they try to kill it, and then I just bounce it with Seal of Removal. That sounds like a really good exchange for me. All right, let's gain 3 life. Take some damage. Take some damages. Sure. Can't really afford to counterspell that. Come on, kill my Orchard Strider. You know you want to. All right, let's gain 3 more life. I need to draw something good. I need to draw my... I have a bunch of Tidings in my deck. Also, the Shaman can't kill creatures, so that's like the main reason that would not work out great. Yeah, I'm afraid I'm going to have to do this. And I think still play this land. So the question... is when they cast the removal spell on my Orchard Strider, do I counter it? And the answer, I think, is no. Because I'm not winning the race anyway. So I think I would rather try to stop their next thing. I'm just going to need to draw something decent anyway. Like a Kaleida Burn or something. Oh, battle plan. Not where I wanted to have the battle planned. I can attack for 4, but then I get attacked back for an extra 1. I don't really like that. I think I will cast battle plan though. Just because, that will make it so maybe I draw something. Oh, that I can't have now. Factory is awesome. Factory is a great card. I mean, I'm not like strictly dead here, but obviously like I'm in a spot where I need to draw something. I think if I draw the, I mean, it's now a draw 6, by the way, if I draw the Lucid Dreams or whatever. No, they had something else. Oh, they had Prophetic Titan? Okay. Wow. They did a good job of slow rolling that, I guess. Okay. Okay. We went from, that went from bad to worse. So... seems like a 3-5 reach would be pretty good in this matchup. Gorilla Shaman didn't look great. Mog smashing is gonna be fine too, yeah, the salvage. Don't want Scuttle Tide. 4-3 reach. Yeah, actually I don't mind the Gouge Zealot either, and I'll take out a battle plan and a Scuttle Tide. Alright. See how this goes. Eh, the blue seal's fine, I think. It's a good, I think it's a decent way to get an enchantment in my graveyard as well. Sure. I mean, I don't love this, but oh, there we go. Now we're fine. Now I get to start looting away. Hopefully I don't kill the Raving Visionary, that would be bad. Oh, this I don't care much about. Sure, you can Tide Shaper me. How much do I want to loot? I think I'll just play the Aerialist first. And we'll decide after. So, what would be really nice is if Menace Modular 2, sure. I kept the hand because if I drew basically any, like an island or a green land cycler, there's just a lot of stuff that could get me there off this hand. Kind of want to discard this forest. Though I guess this is an island, so maybe I discard the island instead. I don't know. I could discard one of the red cards. They both seem fine. And then let's just pass the turn here. Now that this is kind of where we ended up, I'm a little more interested in blocking. Really want to find a mountain. Because then Mog Savage Salvage for free, I think, is going to be pretty good. Oh, geez. Okay. Let's Raving Visionary again. A red-blue land? Yeah, that's kind of what I was hoping for. So now, this is tough. Tough game. I guess I could discard a Kaleidoscorch, sure. It was so shiny, that thing. Oh, I don't really want any of these. Boom. Pass. Hopefully that they like, I was hoping they would like maybe bounce and replay that, but I guess now they have Seal of Removal Thought Monitor, which is pretty gross. This is where drawing a mountain would be pretty nice. Oh, I guess that's a way to put a mountain into play. The only problem with that is I don't get to play anything else this turn. And I kind of feel like I should be playing something else. Actually, let's do it that way anyway. And now I have Delirium, so now what I can do is draw a card with Raving Visionary. And that might entice them to try to Seal of Removal their Thought Monitor. Is the new Faithless Looting playable in Modern? I don't think so. Doesn't sound good to me. Ethereum Spinner. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, I'll take it. I'm at 10. Let's just draw a card here. Draw. How nice of you to show up, Bone Spider. What do I want to do here? Do I want to make the big spider? I kind of want to just make the big spider. Yeah, the Bone Trader's not really working out here. I think I'm just going to play my land. I think I just want more lands in play, even if I have a looter. I'll just discard. I'm probably just going to side out Bone Trader in the swamp, actually, after seeing that they have just mono artifacts here. Okay. Is it time for them to play some Mirror Enforcers? 1, 2, 3, 4. Yep, that's what's coming. Oh. No? Rift Sower? Okay, that's not really what I expected to see coming here. Sure. Then they're going to bounce that. They attack with Ethereum Spinner. I'll probably have to block. Let's see, what do we got here? I mean, the Bone Trader will be good if I draw a land here. I don't think that the tap land really helps. I think I'm just going to take 5 here. I mean, I guess I can smash the Thought Monitor. That's probably fine. Can't kill this. This has modular, so not a good idea to do that. Counterspell's interesting. Now I can play the spider and pass, and maybe counterspell the removal on the spider since they still have. Oh no, that's my graveyard. They don't have the ruin left. Hey, congrats on graduating. Oddly symmetric. Is this a prophetic titan or something? The heck cost 7? Oh, Gargadon. Okay, well, I will counterspell that. All right, they don't have a great attack here. I mean, they could attack with the Hound, kill my Visionary, and then Modular, but then I get to blow up whatever they Modular. So that's pretty good. Oh, okay. Yeah. Wow, all the haters and doubters with Bone Shredder here. Killing their random off-color thing. All right, then I'll play this. Yeah, maybe we're like medium stabilized. I don't know. I've got some stuff. That Arcbound Tracker is a little dangerous. If they had a way to sack artifacts, then they could sack this and modular onto something, and that could be bad as well. The Kaleida scorched my waves. And then cast a Filigree Attendant, dear lord. Okay. I mean, I've got some removals too. I still don't. Is this good? I mean, I like it, I guess. Let's see. There. And then I think I just have to block there. At 7, I think that's the most annoying card. I'll just have to give up on the Raving Visionary, unfortunately. Yeah, that seems good. The other alternative, I could also take 4. I could go Funnelweb. Hold on. What if we do this instead? Eat that, eat that, eat that. I take 4 going to 3. And then I kill this, and then the modular no. This seems better. I take 4 going to 3. Yeah, I mean, I'm not going to have an easy time beating Kaleida Scorch no matter what I do here, I don't think. I guess the alternative is this could block the... Maybe this blocks this. So I take 3 going to 4. That forces them to at least find a third color. Or fourth color. Unfortunately, I can't flash back both Kaleidoscorch and Ruin here. But we'll see. Modular. Yeah. It's gonna be hard to win this game. I need to draw the Make X tokens card. Oh, nice, a battle plan. Let's draw. Well, now we're one short. That was close to being like what I wanted, actually. Because if I could cast Kaleidoscorch and thing, I could kill those two, and then I have Spider against those two. And then they block and go to two and then die. All right. We played against a good deck, a bad deck and won, and a good deck and lost. Or at least, maybe our first round opponent's deck wasn't bad. It just didn't do much. We'll put it that way. Not that our deck's looking great either. I think this deck is quite mediocre. But you know what? If we believe, we can sell all our rares and recoup our value. Let's see what we got. Yeah, the fact that you can sell stuff you open is pretty nice. It's a nice feature of Magic Online for sure. The fact that it's a lot less pretty to play and watch is a big part of why Arena's better. Like, it's pretty nice to play Arena over Magic Online in that sense. How do I like this format? I've been pretty happy with it. This deck's pretty bad, but whatever. It's not the same thing. Magic should be a TCG. Yeah, there's some definite element of truth to that, I will say. Have I played any Modern with the new MH2 cards? I have not. Hey, to Sengir, welcome to the Divination. Yeah, I liked Strixhaven and Sealed a lot. I wouldn't be shocked if Modern Horizons 2 Sealed is pretty good here. All right, let's do it. Yeah, no, I think it's good that the Lords of Limited have been practicing this format a lot, because otherwise the series isn't that fun if we both practice, you know? Like, it's good to keep it competitive. I would like to play first. Oh, yeah, we did it. Meanwhile, me keeping a six land hand. It is kind of annoying that we did draft our deck around the two Delirium Tidings and then just never drew either of them. No, we're not going to cycle the Orchard Strider. Ooh, Mishra's Factory? All right. Well, I'm going to get my bridges out there, and then I'll get the Mishra's Factory down. Oh, hey, what's up, Ben? Ooh, I don't like to see that. I feel like they're going to run some kind of reanimator here. I guess this isn't a very good thing to reanimate anytime soon, but... So I actually have drawn all lands so far. That's not great for my chances. It's pretty good for Gabby's chances, because we're going to get dinner after this, but not so great for my chances. Yeah, I've been pretty underwhelmed by Battle Plan. I mean, the idea is that it helps aid Delirium. So far, that has not been, you know, something that has mattered too much, because I guess I should have tapped it differently. Lazo tapped Chancellor, huh? I'm going to so shiny their thing. Pass the turn. Oh, I still tapped it wrong. Just because this taps for any color, so. Okay. Thought they were going to attack into me. Ooh, I don't mind Road to Ruin. Ooh, artifact and cycling and a mass. The companion's funny because it land cycles, but for all tap lands. So they got a red blue. Yeah. So now they have to wait like an additional extra turn, but it is good for Delirium. Get an artifact and a creature in there. I know, do not know what we're going to have for dinner. I'm sure it'll be great though. Okay. I guess I kind of want to keep Ruin ready in case they do reanimate something. Yeah. Come on now. Are they gonna use the Chancellor again here? I don't know. I did keep a six land hand and I've drawn four lands afterwards. Yeah. Okay. Let's get a blue. Do I pass the turn or do I kill this Lazotep Chancellor? The Lazotep Chancellor is pretty annoying. Yeah. Just pass, I guess. I don't know. Maybe I should kill it. I don't know how many more times they can trigger it here. Seems like they have got something going on, but... So they can put this into play, and then it dies and deals 7 to everything. I mean, reanimating as a sweeper works just fine. So I kept a 6-land hand, they kept a 1-land hand. Oh god. Shockingly, it's working out better for one of us. Let's eat some food here. Okay. There's the Lucid Dreams. Mm-hmm. Let's trade this off. Cast this as my draw 3. Gorilla Shaman has been really bad so far. Not been impressed. Yeah, so if only I had drawn a battle plan, would have been good. Would have been good. Oh, now they can actually pay the upkeep of the dragon if they get it back. Oh god. So now they make 4 squirrels. I can't take it. Oh god. Alright, let's get this Gorilla Shaman out. It's been awful so far. And I don't really know what to put in, because I'm not really liking any of these options. Ooh. This is kind of interesting if they're trying to reanimate some stuff. Hmm, is that good? Ah, mice. Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, battle plan definitely working out here. So look, if I draw red, blue, or green, any of my colors, I have a fixing thing in each color. That's what's called covering your bases. I think I play the... No. Let's just play Road to Ruin here. And get another blue. Oh, God. Okay. I mean, that's a good card. I think I really don't love doing this, but I think I do this and then kill a Lazotep. Ooh, even gets flying. I don't know. It feels like letting them just go off with that. Probably not really what I want to do. So now, I mean, my hand is kind of gassy. Let's see what I can. Can you play Budget, Affinity, and Modern without Mishra's Bauble? Yeah, sure. Why not? Let's do this. They're probably going to cycle and block. Oh, no, they didn't. Interesting. Really? They didn't cycle and block, but now they're going to end of turn cycle? Huh. I wonder if they had like a counterspell or something? Weird. I don't know what's going on over there, but we have an enchantment in the graveyard, so now they must have just drawn this. There's no way you don't do this end of turn. I don't really know what's going on. Okay. Lucid Dreams will be good this game. That I'm not actually worried about. Do you want to trade Burdened Aerialist for a zombie army? No, I'll let them get another cycle onto that, maybe. I could play Junkwinder as just played as a 7-drop. It's not terrible. I could also Yavimaya Elder. I think I'd... No, you know what? Actually, let's just get Junkwinder down. This at least sets up a nice sequence if I draw a way to make tokens. Oh, you joined CFU Prone is great. I love to hear it. Like, imagine if I draw one of the Orchard 6-4s, tap these two down. Now they can't even ambush because they have to amass onto this. So. Let's see. Do they have anything good here? It's been kind of weird trying to figure out what they've got. Because they had that turn where they had 4 mana and they didn't do anything. I don't know. Like I said, I'm not... It's not obvious to me what's going on. You joined CFP Pro yesterday and hit Mythic today? There we go. Orchard 6-4, yeah. This is rough because I assume my opponent's going to win, but we're going to take some time before killing me. Oh, okay. Yeah, that's dead. Good beats, I guess. Oh, then we had it. We even drew it. Stupid. Do we even want to cast this? Yeah, it's 6-4. Doesn't really attack through that. Those the part of the problem. Yeah, it's still probably fine. What is in their hand? They just keep doing nothing. Let's see. Oh, God. Chainer. Okay. So you can discard a card and you can cast a creature out of your graveyard. Wow, they could have just discarded that and cast the Chancellor instead. I assume that's even better. But Artifact Land. Come on. Oh. Oh, wow. This is rough. I kind of want all of these things. Now I've got to keep sweep this guys, and I think Lucid Dreams is going to draw me more cards than Yavimaya Elder. So now I think I'm going to hit with the Orchard Strider. Let's see what they got. I mean, what they got is probably chomping with their zombie army, but that's okay. I mean, their deck seems quite a bit better than ours. Ours. Wait. Oh, wait, that doesn't help. So, playing the island doesn't help. Blue, blue, black, red, green. Whew. I'm going to play my island. I don't have Delirium yet. I have Enchantment, Creature, Sorcery, but I'm still just going to use this. The fact that this could help me hit Delirium is a pretty big game. Could I think of any good reason they don't have Phantom MH2 drafts on Arena? Coding all the old cards into Arena, I assume, is the cost that they don't want to pay. Oh no, they have their own Thopter Squad. Well, I don't like seeing that. Yeah, their deck is pretty good. I like this, these lands and this Ornithopter really pulling their weight on the madness thing here. All right. Okay, good, good, good. Now I have Delirium. Give me the fourth card type. Draw. I think I just cast Lucid Dreams. Ooh, Spreading Insurrection could be good. Wow, Bone Shredder's just trash again. You love to see it. I mean, you don't love to see it, but... classic Bone Shredders. Yeah, I kind of want to get these Thopters out of the way, so I'm just going to hit like this and we'll see what they do. Block. Because with Spreading Insurrection, you want to have as few creatures as possible. I mean, you need creatures to steal, but you don't want to have them have easy blocks. So I think trading stuff off is good. I mean, I do have this Looter now. I can start drawing me cards. So... that's good, at least. I mean, I don't feel great about the situation. I see. So they're going to kill my Looter now. Mm-hmm. Ooh, Seal of Removal. That's interesting, too. So they're going to do this, and then they're going to play their Lazotep Chancellor. Yeah, I mean, I can, when I steal Chainer, I can play stuff, so I guess that part is kind of cool. Okay, they're at 14. Wow, Bone Shredder's so bad. So anyway, I can't quite kill them this turn. Let's see. Shredder is not optional, but I could shred my own Ignoble Hierarch. So if I have enough mana to do all that. Let's say if I did all that. I played Seal, played Shredder, kill my own Ignoble Hierarch, play Spreading Insurrection, and there'd be three copies. I can steal those three, attack with everything. They block. No, it doesn't kill them. So this is tough. The other hand, I could also just play Seal of Removal, Spreading Insurrection, and then off of Chainer, I could play some stuff. I have three tokens. Off of Chainer, I could just play the Junk Winder. Yeah, Sealing Ignoble Hierarch. Let's see. This is Menace. So if I bounce that, steal those two. Well, if I bounce the Zombie Army and I steal those two. Let's see. One, two. I steal those three. No. Let's see. They block 9 points of damage. And then they take 3, 4, 5. Cause this, if I sack a token, so let's see, if I play seal. Oh no, they block, they only get to have one. And then they block that and they take 3, 5, 10, 13, 15. Oh, that I think that actually works for me. Is that right? I bounce a Lazotep. And then I steal those three. And then they block one and they take 10. Yeah, that should be enough. Okay. Sheesh. You know, you know you're in bad trouble when your opponent tanks for a while and then bone shredders their own creature. Yoink. 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 Boom. Yeah, I think we got there. All right, spreading insurrection. Nice little miser sideboard plan. That worked out nice. We're really not going to beat their deck unless things like that happen, to be honest. Oh, yeah. All right, let's take out Bonecher in the swamp. Add in probably just a mountain here. And put in like the Durf Gouge Zealot. Oh, it added one too many lands. It added an island. Yeah, okay. Hey, what's up, Eric? Yes, Jeg Viking. I cast Insurrection, the card from Onslaught, to beat him in a game he thought he could never lose. One of the first times we met, just drafting at the local store. It was great. Oh, yeah. Gouge Zealot, you get in there. Okay. This looks like a solid start, and they don't have a turn 2 Lazotep Chancellor, though. They do have a turn 2 Ornithopter. I don't like that. All right, I'm not going to play Seal It or Cycle Battle Plan here. Chrome Courier, very nice. All right, they're going to get a dam. Well, damn. All right, it's fine. We can deal. Let's get a forest here. And play the forest, and I guess play the Burdened Aerialist. Oh yeah, Spreading Insurrection does seem kind of unbeatable in 2HG. I'll give you that. So, okay. I'm going to go get their like artifact red-blue land or something. The way to play around Spreading Insurrection, Sponzi, is to like not let the board get to a big board stall. Easier said than done, but that would be the way. That is the way. Let's just cast the Gouged Zealot here. Pass. Oh, okay. I mean, given that they have a Wrath in their hand, they have Dam in their hand. Not really bothered if they want to play some 2-for-1 room or in some removal like that. This is awkward. I guess I'll just play the Orchard Strider. I mean, I don't know. I'm not really waiting for much here. I think at this point, I'm probably also going to attack and trade the Aerialist. Oh, no, I guess I already have a creature. So what is the advantage of not trading here? I don't really have, like, a deal one. Let's just hit. That's fine. I don't think I get much value out of waiting. I don't really care about using Seal to save the Orchard Strider. If they want to use Dam and kill their own thing. Or no, I guess they're just going to use the black-black version. That's fine. I'm not really that worried about that. Okay. Okay, that was pretty nice. A mountain here. Now we're on four card types. Now we're cooking. Hierarch. Now I'll play the seal and pass the turn. And if they want to kill my Orchard Strider, they can, but I'm going to get to draw some cards next turn. And I could actually use Ruin to kill their Lazotep Chancellor as well. Can I bounce my Orchard Strider if they want? Yeah, Seal Removal is good. This card's a pretty solid card. Just never having to spend mana on it once it's in play is pretty nice. You get to do some pretty good work there. They at least so far haven't had a very good Lazotep Chancellor draw, which is nice. I don't mind that. Dehada's Ploy. Okay. It's going to help. So they draw two and discard a card. Then they gain a life because they've discarded one card, and then they get to make a 2/2. Pretty good deal. They get to flash it back later and do it again. Yeah, I'm afraid I have to do this. Yeah, I'll take some damage. I mean, this gives me the treasure token, so it's not like that big of a deal. Extremely obvious mana tapping, but it's okay. Yeah, this counterspell hasn't been great. I'm not countering Dehada's Ploy if they play that again. Or Chrome Courier. Sure. They revealed another Lazotep Chancellor. And an island. Yeah, I might have to counter a Lazotep Chancellor. Oh, are they considering the island? Interesting. So they must really want to play Dehada's Ploy this turn or something. I guess that does give them a good attack with the zombie army. No, they took the Chancellor. All right. Really? 13. I think I'm just going to kill that thing. And I take 8. Yeah, sure. Tragic Fall. No, I don't like that. I'm going to pass on that. All right. Ooh, Wave Sifter seems like a much better version of casting Lucid Dreams here. Pass. Okay, so I'm basically at 8 here. Which means they don't have great attacks, especially since this can block the Underworld Hermit. This blocks the zombie, yeah, or maybe even just blocks the Chrome Courier. Also, a factory, it can block a squirrel and steal a sack of food. Okay, if they're going to spend a turn resetting with a Lazotep into Dehada's Ploy, I'm okay with that. Yes, this is where the Junk Trawler thing would be really good. Junk Winder, Junky Dubs. Okay. Oh, let's see. This is an instant. Yeah, so how much do I care about trading for a 4/4 here? Yeah, that's probably fine. Oh, I guess they also would have gotten to do it again if they had more mana. All right. I'm just going to crack clues here. I'd rather crack clues before food because I want to see what my options are And if I don't have good ones, I'll just crack the food later. So shiny. Okay. I mean, if I tap down the Hermit, that does go a long way. I'm at 5. I can also kill the Lazotep Chancellor. Maybe that's fine. Let's tap down the Hermit first. Okay, I don't really want those. I think I kill the Lazotep Chancellor here. And I've got a couple blockers. They don't even have lethal out. I think that's okay. I don't know. This is close. We're actually going to win the game if it goes too long, obviously. Like, you know, they could still play like an 8-8 dragon or something, and that would be a problem. But young Necromancer. So they're going to exile 2 cards from their graveyard, and they get back a Lazotep Chancellor, I guess. Sure. That's fine. Now I think I'm going to sack a food, because my plan is to cast Lucid Dreams. Oh, they're just going to get back a 4-4. Okay, sure, that makes sense too. And so I want to make sure I have the life total to do that. Oh, not the time for that. Let's draw 3. Oh, they had their own counterspell. Okay. Sure. Didn't really anticipate that off their mana base, but there we go. Okay. That's 2-3. I'm at 8, though, so I have a little bit of wiggle room here. Now I have 4 card types. See? Even better. I have enchantment creature, sorcery, and I guess instant. So now... I'm going to offer the trade I made before. No, unfortunately not land, because I'm going to keep Misha's Factory around. They chose to do it this way instead, which makes sense. No. I need them to, like, take one turn off. Oh, God. Now they get to sack Underworld Hermit to kill my Misha's Factory. This is really not helping. Okay. Let's draw. Well, now I do have 5 card types. Let's draw 5. 8. What to do? That was not even a particularly good 5 cards. Wow. I guess I'm going to play. No, if I play Burden Aerialist, I just die. Well, if I block Young Necromancer, which is what I want to do. Let's just pass. God, this is so bad. I could Kaleidoscorch. Something for 2. No, none of this is really going to work. I can't beat them having more stuff, whatever it is. Yeah, I mean, well, I don't know what they're going to get back here, but they're going to counterspell, so I have 1 turn to... Oh, no, they have that. Of course. Of course, it all works out. Yeah, I mean, I was pretty dead either way, I think. Actually, this. Yeah, I have to block there. Sack this. Yeah, and then I draw, and then I don't know, they have, like, a way out of this. Wow, managed to draw 5 cards and none of them were good. All right, well, a somewhat deserved 1-2, I think. This deck was pretty bad. But, you know, Modern Horizons is pretty fun. So check out Channel Fireball for more Modern Horizons drafts. Well, here on ChannelFireball.com. Thanks for watching.